Apple's Mac Mini has had a redesign from the ground up, and holy guacamole is this thing small. This thing looks just like a tiny version of a Mac Studio, and while that signature Apple aluminium finish is nice to look at, it's a fingerprint magnet. Here's a side-by-side comparison with the M1 Mac Mini, and you can see Apple has hit this thing with a shrink ray. How in the world did they fit everything the Mini needs in here? Thanks to our friends over at Lumafield, we're able to get a sneak preview of how Apple did it. Right away, we can see just how densely packed this thing is. You might have noticed too that the power supply unit is no longer a single module. It's now a board that extends across the top of the case, a la the HomePod. One much griped about and much defended change has been the decision to move the power button from the back of the device to the bottom plate. Some folks feel pretty strongly that Apple's obsession with aesthetics might have gone too far. But don't fret, there are plenty of clever 3D printed solutions to fix this. Now let's see what else we can find inside. On with the teardown. The shell is a solid chunk of aluminium, so I need to flip this little turtle on its back to get at the soft underbelly. The bottom plate is held in by clips, but a pick can be forced between the seams without causing damage, and it's just a matter of working my way around the edges to unlatch the four clips securing each corner. I'm being extra careful around that power button as there's bound to be some cables nearby. And sure enough, the power button is sitting in the corner waiting for me, and it's the first component to get disconnected. 2024 will be remembered as the year of the CMOS battery. Apple's not the only company to consider ease of access to routine system maintenance. Our Sony PS5 Pro teardown is also underway, and we'll have a similar story to share on that front too. This lithium button cell battery, like all lithium batteries, is a consumable that'll need to be replaced eventually. The inner plate is the next component to come away. The four outer screws secure the plate to the chassis, while a further four screws secure the thermal assembly to this plate. On the underside, there's a flex cable secured under a smaller circular plate, and judging from the coax cables, this must be the wireless module. And now that I've made my way to the inner sanctum of the Mac Mini, I think I can remove this fan, which takes up about half the space on this layer of components. The M4 Mac Mini has an entirely redesigned thermal management system, and this fan is doing a lot of novel work to keep that M4 cool. The base of the Mac Mini allows it to pull in air from the surrounding environment, and the air is able to circulate throughout the device before being vented back out through the bottom. Pretty remarkable. Here's an interesting difference between the M4 and the M4 Pro Minis. That beefier chip needs a beefier cooling solution, and the M4 Pro has a bigger copper heatsink when compared to the smaller aluminium heatsink found in the base model M4s. Once the fan is out, I have access to the single NAND storage card. Unlike the Mac Studio that had two ports, the M4 Mac Mini only has a single port. Here's a Mac Mini 256GB module alongside a 512GB module. The two cards are identical, except for the NAND chips themselves. So we swapped them between machines to see what would happen. After running it through Apple Configurator, and to our great surprise, it worked. Storage upgrades are possible. Unfortunately, the NAND modules are not exactly the same for every version of this new Mini. The base model M4 and M4 Pro use physically different modules that aren't interchangeable, and our attempts at trying to boot an M4 Pro machine with a standard M4 drive gave us a lot of issues. So, when you're upgrading your drive in the future, just make sure you're getting the correct drive for your model. It's now time to remove the speaker and figure out how to remove the logic board. The speaker is easy enough to deal with, finding a path forward is a little less obvious. It looks like the modular front ports need to come out first. Removable and replaceable ports are great for repairability. These parts suffer loss of mechanical wear from the constant plugging and unplugging of cables, so being able to replace them without having to desolder ports is fantastic. And an honorable mention for the front-facing headphone jack. Great news for music lovers and high-fidelity audio aficionados. Next, I'm going to remove the only two screws on the heatsink on this side of the board before moving on to this hefty screw pillar. What a chonker! These Torx screws use the biggest bit we have in our Mako kit. A little maneuvering and the rear ports slide up and out and release the logic board from the shell. The only thing left to do is to disconnect the cable connecting the logic board to the PSU underneath. There's a plastic layer protecting the logic board from the exposed power supply unit. It feels like it's held down by a bit of glue, but it turns out that it also sticks against the copper thermal layer that lines most of the underside of the logic board. Hidden underneath the copper film are four screws securing the thermal management system against the M4 system on chip. A Unlike the replaceable and surprisingly upgradable NAND module, the RAM for the M4 is tightly integrated into the SoC architecture and is not upgradable. The non-upgradable RAM aside, I am super impressed with the modular design, ease of access, the day one release of repair manuals, and most of all, the upgradable storage on these new Mac Minis. The powerful M4 processor combined with user upgradable and removable storage should mean that consumers can potentially get at least a decade of use out of this device, assuming the logic board doesn't break. The soldered rear ports are also a bit of a downer on an otherwise modular device, but all in all, this Mac Mini has a bright and repairable future ahead of it. With all that in mind, we're giving the Mac Mini M4 and Mac Mini M4 Pro a provisional score of 7 out of 10. Nice work, Apple.